Hello children, welcome once again to your English literature class. I hope all of you are fine and taking very good care of yourselves. So if you remember, in the last session we had done the poem The River. Today we shall be doing the reference to context, question and answers, and also the appreciation of the poem. So all of you can get ready with your books on page number 123. The river's a wanderer, a nomad, a tramp. She doesn't choose one place to set up her camp. The river's a winder, through valley and hill. She twists and she turns, she just cannot be still. Now in these lines you can see wanderer, nomad, tramp. What do these three words tell us about the river? Those who have done your word meanings, you all know the meaning of these three words. And all these three, they do not stay in one place. So these three words tell us that the river also keeps moving from place to place. The second question is, what are the different places that the river flows past in the poem? So you have to see the lines that are given to you. You can see valley and hill are mentioned. So you need to write, the river flows past the valley and the hill. In your own words, give the meaning of to set up camp. So whenever you are setting up a camp means you are going to stay at that place. Fine. So to set up camp means to settle down. Now one thing children, you all must have noticed, the lines of the poem, R is written in capital for river. You must be knowing the reason by now. I had already explained in the previous video, I just repeat again, capital R suggests that the river is personified in the poem. Okay, it is treated as a person. The question B, the river's a hoarder and she buries down deep all those little treasures she wants to keep. Why is the river called a hoarder? We know a person, a hoarder is a person who collects things. So river is also called a hoarder because she collects things and stores them deep down. Which word means puts deep inside? If you carefully go through the four lines that are given to you as the context, you can see the word buries written in the second line. So the word buries means put deep inside. Question number three. What do you think are the treasures that the river wants to keep? I had already explained, you all should know the answer. The treasures that the river wants to keep are sand, pebbles and other living creatures. So this is all for your reference to context. And now we shall proceed to the other questions. So now I hope all of you are ready with your books in your hand. And as you can see, it's written the river appreciation. So we are going to learn something else other than the question and answers. But before we start with appreciation, we are going to learn something more about the river. Okay, so page number 124. Circle the groups of words that describe what the river does not do. Okay, you have to circle the words which is not the activity of the river. Now stay still. River does not stay still. We all know you have read about the words nomad, tramp. The river is always traveling, no, always moving. So we will circle stay still. The river never stays still. Again, stay in one place. It means all the same. The river never stays in one place, but it flows. No, in the countryside, it keeps flowing silently. Give away her treasures. No. The river does not give away her treasures. We read just before we did. It buries all the treasures deep down. So you will circle. Stay still. Stay in one place. And give away her treasures. The next question says, why does the poet call the river a singer? The poet calls the river a singer. Why? Because we read in the poem, no, the countryside echoes notes of her song. So this question we'll be doing in the notebook also. Now question number 5. This is for you to think and reflect. In this poem, many comparisons have been used to describe the river. Think of a river you have seen
And is there anything else you can compare a river to? Most of you must have seen a river whenever you travel, no, by road, you must have seen rivers. So can you think of some other comparisons? Now this is all your creativity, okay? And this you can do it in your rough copy as an exercise. You don't have to do it in your notebook, okay? You will do it on your own. So now we will move towards the appreciation of the poem. The poet describes the sounds the river makes. The river hums, gurgles, sings, and sounds like she is sucking her thumbs. If you remember, like a child, you know, sucking the thumb, it's making that gurgling sound. We had done that when I was explaining the poem. So here are few more lines given to you in which we describe the sounds that water makes. Now you need to read these lines aloud. All these are sound words, children. Previous poems you have learnt about personification, you've learnt about syllables, so many things. So today you are learning about sound words. The rock fell into the pond with a loud splash. So splash is a sound word. You need to underline it, okay? Underline it with your pencils. The rock fell into the pond with a loud splash. So when you hear the word splash, it is the sound of water will come to your ears. Number B, I emptied the pot and let fresh water gurgle into it. Gurgle means all that gurgling noises when water you are filling in it. Gurgle. The calm water softly lapped the shores of the lake. You will not say that the water is gurgling the shores. No, the water is lapping. You can imagine those overlapping waves. The huge waves crashed against the rocks. Now, if it's an ocean, a sea, the waves are very big, giant, gigantic. So they crash against the rocks of the seashore. If you have been by a seaside, you must have seen the wave comes with lot of speed, and when it just strikes the rocks, the water is crashed. The heavy rain drummed down on my roof. Drummed. It is making that noise on the roof. No, drummed. I could hear the pitter-patter of the gentle rain. So gentle rain will not make a loud thundering noise. It will make a pitter-patter sound. Okay. So these are all the sound words, you know, and if you learn these words, these new words, when you are writing your essays and your letters, anything descriptive, you can use these words in your creative writing. Okay, next we will turn and see another poem that is given in your book. Here are a few lines from a poem called Sounds of a School Morning by Shefali Martins. Read the lines aloud and circle the sound words. Okay, this is a morning poem. Sounds of a school morning. You go to school early morning. What kind of sounds do you hear? You may tomorrow get an essay, no? Write an essay on the morning sounds. So you will, this is going to help you. That is the reason I tell you to read more books, stories and poems. The clock chimes in the hall to tell us it's 6 o'clock. You can see all the words have already circled. So right now you try to listen and enjoy the poem. The words are already circled. You can also see and circle them. Okay. The click of the door says, Grandma is going for a walk. Busy little sparrows twitter on the neem tree. Pots and pans clang as breakfast is made for me. Then beep, honk, beep calls the school bus horn. We make a line and then turn by turn get on. At school, everybody is full of laughter and chatter. As long as we are polite, a little noise does not matter. And then we get alert as the school bell goes ding dong. The assembly starts and we proudly sing our school song. We walk briskly to our classes and now we are quiet. Except for our shoes that patter left, right, left, right. So I hope all of you enjoyed listening to the poem. Listen to the pronunciation. Try to read. And I'm very sure you must all be recollecting the good times you were having in school, no? All of you must be wanting to come back to school. You all hear these sounds when you come to school early morning. So I hope we also will meet very soon. Till then, all of you take very good care of yourselves. Okay. Now in this poem, they have also given you to write a poem with sound words. for your own self. That is not to show to your teachers. So enjoy. Happy writing. Take care of yourselves. Till we meet again. Thank you.